In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to chip carve this beautiful small candle holder. You can see we've got two designs on each of the sides. Very similar, just with a slight alteration that I'll show you how to carve. Stay tuned for this lesson. I know you'll enjoy it. I'm just about finished putting the pattern onto this candle holder. I taped the pattern onto my basswood blank with a tape hinge up on top. Slip my graphite transfer paper underneath and trace over the lines that I want to transfer onto my wood. Before you take the pattern off of your blank, lift it up and check to make sure that you've got all your lines transferred onto the wood. If not, just simply flip her back down and do the ones that you've missed. On this pattern, you can see that I used my T-square and a pencil to draw these lines here, and these lines up and down here. So I drew the outline with my pencil, and I divided that rectangle also with a straight edge and a pencil. I like using pencil lines on some of these patterns because they're crisper, I can draw a straighter line, and they're much easier to erase. So now that I have my pattern drawn on all four sides of my basswood blank, we're all ready to start carving. Seeing as this candle holder is quite small, I'm going to carve it still on my lap, but I've rested it on top of another board that sits across my lap. That gives me more stability and more control, so I don't have to try to fight holding this tiny little candle holder. I'm going to start with my main cutting knife here. Same first position, thumb, knuckle, and knife blade as I make these cuts. You can see this pattern here, I'm splitting it down the middle of each of these to make two chips back to back. I'm going to start by cutting on the line, shallow. There's the wide part of the chip, get a little depth on it, and then draw it out right to the center of your piece. Now for economy of movement, I'm going to do this on all four of these chips. Right down the line. There's the deep part, and draw it out. If your pattern doesn't match your lines, follow the lines. I'm going to follow this straight line instead of the carbon transfer line because it's more accurate. The other ones, remember, these are just guidelines. You do the carving, let the lines guide you. Alright, now I'll cut the other side of those chips. Shallow, there's the deep part, and draw it out right up to the corner. I'm working in this direction, so I'm carving away from my previous chips. And I'm also trying to carve away as much of the lines on my wood as possible so I don't have to erase as much when I'm all done. When you get to the end, watch out that you don't slip off the end. Notice I just rock the knife down. Okay, those four chips are done. Now I'll carve away from those previous chips by taking the first cut on the line away from those bigger chips. and take out those chips. I'm just going to work on the other side right from here and work my way to the deep part of the chip and draw the knife out. Here's the delicate part of the chip, right down in the center, so don't go too deep, otherwise you get some chip out. I'm going to work in this direction again and take out the next chip. All right, there we have the main part of the pattern cut out. Now I'll take out these inner details inside here in this manner. All right, now I got to remember which way I went on this previous one. Looks like I cut that direction first. So back here, here's my next cut. Right to there. And to take the chip out, start right at the point, plunge it straight down in, and draw it right out to the center. So we start shallow, up on the top. There's a deep part of the chip. Plunge your knife in and draw it out to the point. Alright, we've taken out those main chips on this design. Let's take the border out now. Same procedure as the other side. I'm going to take the straight cuts first. Look slightly ahead of my knife. Here's my choice. And when it's all done, here's what it looks like. Our candle holder is completely finished now. And you can see the finish I've chosen to put on the candle holder is a stained finish. Here's the steps I used to finish this.